don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want, gratis.
Yeah.
A pair of new shoes with matching
ones. Michael, we're not doing the show. Go change.
Thank you.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Amazo, and what you're about to witness is the epitome of control, planning, and precise timing which has never been seen before, until today. Now, when I say the word, which will be divulged to you in a moment's time, these individuals you see before you will rise from their chairs and perform a chain reaction of eloquent and believable character performances that would not be possible without my unique and, dare I say, amazing abilities. Not fire. My house? My Beanie Baby collection? I'm sorry, folks. It seems the doctor's had a personal emergency. One I won't go into further detail for his personal reasons.
Oh, my Beanie Baby!
Anyways, we have prepared for this situation. Though I may not be the amazing Dr. Amazo, I am the equally impressive Dr. Subparo. Let's see here.
Flyball! Flyball! Flyball!
All right. Anyway, on these cards are the sequence of events on which today's show relies. These intricately constructed cards, these actors will follow the sequence of events to a T. It's okay. Nobody panic.
Help! Help! Police!
Help! Help me! The police are here!
You never take me alive, Kappa!
Dangerous and lively this show can get, so everybody strap in as we begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are nearing departure, so flight attendants will be making final checks. Please remain seated with your seatbelts fastened and your seats in their upright positions.
You heard the men, get in position!
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy, a Yankee Doodle Do or Die, the real proud nephew of my own.
Let ball!
Let's try something else. You, whom I have my hand on, you will rise in your name and state your purpose for being here at the snap of my fingers.
My name is Carol, and I'm here to hopefully cure my greatest fear.
Excuse me?
My greatest fear. I heard of hypnotherapy and...
This is not hypnotherapy. This is entertainment hypnotics. It's for entertainment. It's not a doctor's office.
But it was free, and I just...
Very well. What is your greatest fear?
Well, at first I thought it might be police officers, but I've come to realize it's really anyone in uniform.
Excuse me?
Yeah, police officers, soldiers, flight attendants, hell, even baseball players.
Sleep!
What?
Sleep! Go back to sleep!
You heard the men, get! position!
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy, a Yankee Doodle Doodle Dandy.
Murderesses of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
He had it coming.
I said, you pop that gun one more time.
He did.
So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots
into his head.
He had a gun.
Go ahead.
Lust. Mother, this is not a
nonsense, Alice.
was.
It's all right.
Sir, it's not all right.
Oh, I don't know. Seems to me that's a perfectly fair word.
Now you see, Alice, you mustn't interrupt the game.
What was that last one again?
Lust, Mr. Kirby.
I got it.
This is quite the game.
Shh, please. Are we all ready? Honeymoon. All right, the last word is sex.
Mother!
Everybody got sex? All right! Now I'm going to collect your papers. Here.
What happens next?
Oh, this is the best part. Now I get to read out your reactions. I'm going to read yours first, Mr. Kirby. Everybody ready? This is Mr. Kirby's paper. Potatoes, steak. Well, that's good. You see how they go together? Steak and potatoes?
I just happened to think of it.
Oh, well, it's very good. Let's see here. Bathroom, toothpaste. Wow! Lust, unlawful. Isn't that nice? Honeymoon? Trip? Yes! And sex? Mail? Oh, yes, of course you are.
It's really quite a wonderful game, Mr. Kirby.
Thank you. It's more than just a game, isn't it? It's an experiment in psychology.
Well, yes, it is. It just shows how your mind works. Now we're going to see how Mrs. Kirby's mind works. Everybody ready? Potatoes? Start! I know just what you mean, Mrs. Kirby. Dear! All right, bathroom. Mr. Kirby.
What's that?
Bathroom, Mr. Kirby.
I don't quite follow that, my dear.
Oh, I don't know. I just thought of you in connection with it. After all, you are in there a good deal, Anthony, bathing and shaving. Well, you do take a long time.
Oh, indeed. I hadn't realized I was being selfish in the matter. Please, continue, Mrs. Sycamore.
I think it's a very silly game, and we have to stop it!
Yes.
No, please continue.
Where was I? Let's see here. Lust. Human.
Human? Really, Muriel?
Well, all I meant, Anthony, is that lust is, after all, a human emotion.
Lust is not a human emotion. It is depraved.
Very well, Anthony. I'm wrong.
Really, it's the most pointless game. Suppose we play 20 questions?
Yes.
No, I find this game rather interesting. What was the next word, Mrs. Sycamore?
Honeymoon.
And what was Mrs. Kirby's response?
Honeymoon. Dull.
Dull. Did you say dull?
Well, what I meant, Anthony, is that Hot Springs was not very gay that season. All those old people sitting on the porch all afternoon and nothing to do at night.
That was not the reaction at the time, as I recall.
Father, it's just the game.
A very illuminating game, isn't it? Continue.
All right. Oh, this one's perfect! Sex? Wall Street?
What was that?
A sex? Wall Street.
What does that one mean, Mira?
I don't know, Anthony. Nothing.
Well, it must be something, otherwise you wouldn't have written it down.
It was just the first thing that popped into my head.
But what does it mean? Sex? Wall Street?
Well, I don't know, Anthony. It's just you're always talking about Wall Street, even when... Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, my. Would you mind terribly, Alice, if we didn't stay for dinner?
Trade Center in New York City.
Well,
Obviously, that's a big story. There's no doubt about it.
So how big of a headline, Fox? 244 or 300?
Now,
I say 300 because this is going to be a story people are going to want to save for years and years. I mean, come on, guys. This is history.
Now, hold on, Phil. We all agree the World Trade Center. It's a big story. Well, let's see what other lead ideas we have around. Lauren?
Well, we have...
Hold on. Other stories? Possible terrorists attack the World Trade Center. I mean, that's your lead story right there.
Listen, Phil, this whole attack thing's gonna be it.
In? Terrorist attack? What more do you need to say? The whole front page is right there.
Look, Phil, we've heard your side. We know you're hot on the whole World Trade Center camp. But, you know, there's other reporters in the room. Let's see what they have to say. They work here, too. Jimmy, what do you got in sports?
Well, the Lady Crusaders basketball team from the high school is really racking up their baskets.
Really?
Mm-hmm. They have a real shot at going to the finals this year.
Yeah, I heard they had quite a good chance.
Gentlemen, we are at war!
Phil, sit down. Jesus. What are you saying? The Lady Crusaders is our lead story. But I mean, it is local. Do we have a single Islamic terrorist in Ottumwa, Iowa?
Hundreds of people died in the buildings. That's what the president said.
Lauren, how about you? The police beat?
Apparently the first pickpocket of the year may have happened this morning.
Pickpocket here in town?
Yeah. Old man Murphy thinks someone took his wallet. Mrs. Murphy thinks he lost a room on the couch.
Anything else?
Well... Oh! There were some kids who broke into the local high school and cost $4,000 worth of damage to some computers, say.
$4,000 in damages?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Well, see, now, Phil, that is something that directly affects our readers. They're going to have to pay for those computers. Carly, what's cooking and what?
I'll tell you what's happening in weather! It's raining planes in New York City! That's what's happening in weather!
It was a little windy on my way over here. Is there anything to that?
Yes, as a matter of fact, there is time. We might have a possible tornado watch on our hands.
Now, is that the same thing as a tornado warning?
No, there are three stages. Watch, alert, and warning!
So you're telling me there's a possibility we might be hit by a tornado?
Yep.
Well, see, now, Phil, aren't you glad we talked about this?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Erica Jones.
And I'm Karen A. News Lady.
We come to you with breaking news. An elderly man and a middle-aged woman got into a brawl over the last crab leg at a Meteor Buffet in Huntsville, Alabama.
The two Huntsville citizens were apparently waiting a good 10 to 15 minutes before the fresh crab legs came out. On the scene now is Brittany Stedman.
Brittany?
It's your turn, intern.
What?
You're talking about the stabbing over the crab.
I am? Someone was stabbed?
Yes.
Over crab?
Yes.
That's pretty wild. Why would someone do that?
Read from your script, damn it!
Karen, can I get a do-over?
Sweetheart, you're an idiot.
God bless her heart.
Thank you, Karen.
Now please get back to the script. We are on air, darling, and you're making us look like complete laughingstocks. So please. Do your job.
Do your damn job before I do it for you, intern.
Two diners began using tongs as swords and shattering plates.
Why? Don't you ask the lady next to you like you're supposed to.
Right. Hello, Miss Mary Beth. How's your day going?
My day was going just fine until I walked out of the bathroom to see a brawl going on in a freaking buffet. There's enough for everyone. That's the damn point of a buffet.
Pretty whack.
Oh, there was a whack, all right. Chiquita took a pair of tongs and sliced poor John's head right open.
Back to you, Eric.
This job.
isn't paying me enough to do what this
woman— Isn't there another story we can switch to?
Yes, thank you, Cam. Recently, a Texas man was arrested for essentially stealing fajitas.
Researchers tell us that in court, Gilberto Escamilla admits to stealing fajita products for over 9 years.
He had been ordering fajitas for his workplace and had been selling them for profits for so long that he racked up $1.2 million.
Escamilla was found guilty. He'll be serving 15 years in prison.
The assistant district attorney was hoping that a strong message would be sent for this man's punishment.
Yeah, kids, don't steal fajita meat, steal taco meat instead.
Next, a man named Jason Steiber fights a ticket for talking on his phone while driving.
Steiber claims it wasn't his cell phone, but a McDonald's hash brown that he was holding up to his face.
The police officer claims that he saw the illuminated cell phone up to his face and saw his mouth move.
Steiber simply says that while he was enjoying his fresh hash brown patty, the police pulled him over and insist they made a mistake.
So far, Steiber has spent more money fighting the ticket than he would have actually spent just paying the ticket.
In front of a local McDonald's is Brittany. Brittany?
Hi, Karen.
You're on the air.
No, I'm not. I'm on the ground, silly.
Okay, you're script, you idiot.
Sweetheart, we need you to read from the script, okay?
I don't really like the script, though. Can I just make it up on the fly? Don't worry, though. I'm still on the ground.
I swear. Stand. One more mistake and I'll—
Hang on! Brittany, you were just about to introduce us to Mr. Steiber's lawyer.
Uh-huh. Hello, Mr. Thigerson.
Hello, Miss Stedman. Thank you for having me.
Ooh, I really like your voice. You sound like my bus driver when I was 12.
Thank you?
His name was Paul.
Get on with it!
Could you tell us a little bit about your client?
Well, I can't say this. I know when my clients are full of crap, and I've heard some crap. I really think he's telling the truth this time, though. Really was a hash brown.
This bimbo is an actual lawyer?
He has a degree.
No. I think that police officer has something against hash browns. You never really see a cop with anything but coffee and donuts, I tell you.
Okay. I think that's all for today. Signing off, I'm Erica Jones.
And I'm Karen A. Newslady.
I'm Brittany Stedman.
That's all for 8 o'clock news.
Now for 9 o'clock news featuring Desmond.
To others and silence your cell phones now.
$1 home. I've got to teach my son.
Down on stage. Fine, they can kill the music. I'll turn the horse lights.